Now, the first step in Thomas' algorithm is going to be to make this particular element, this pivot element, equal to 1 by dividing the entire row by that particular element. So, we will write step 1. The first part is divide R1 by A11, okay. That is what we are going to do. The next step in case of Gauss elimination was to use the pivot element, or sorry, not the pivot element, but the pivot row. So, to use the pivot row R1 to get zeros in C1 below the diagonal, okay. So, this was the second step, the second part of step 1 in Gauss elimination. Now, let us go and look at what kind of structure we have in the tridiagonal matrix, okay. Now, in the tridiagonal matrix, row 2 has a non-zero element, row 3 does not have a non-zero element, row 4 does not have a non-zero element up to row n. None of these rows have non-zero elements in their column 1 below the diagonal, only one row has non-zero element, okay. That is the first thing to keep in mind. The second thing to keep in mind is that in row 1, this particular element is going to be non-zero. This element is 0, so this guy minus anything multiplied by this guy is going to remain this, this minus anything multiplied by this is going to remain this, and so on and so forth. So, for wherever I am marking this x marks, we are not going to need to do any calculations at all, okay, and we will need to do one more calculation over here, okay. So, what it means in order to row use the pivot row, we will use the row R1 to get 0 in this particular element. That is the only thing that that is needed, and once we get 0 in this particular element, the only element that is going to change is A22 and B2. None of the other elements are going to change at all. So, what we are going to do over here is we are going to rewrite this, use pivot row R1 to convert A21 equal to 0, okay. That we are going to do by writing R2 equal to R2 minus A21 multiplied by R1, okay. And unlike Gauss elimination, okay, there are not going to be n steps in this, there are only going to be 2 steps. Why there are 2 steps? Because only 2 elements are non-zero, A12 and B1, these are the only non-zero elements, okay. Because of this, what we are going to have is A22 new is going to be equal to A22 old minus A21 multiplied by A12 new, okay. This is going to be one equation. And the other equation is going to be B2 is going to be equal to B2 old minus A21 multiplied by B1 old, okay. So, these are the only 2 equations or only 2 expressions that we are going to actually solve for when we are going to use R1 in order to get the pivot element, the elements in the pivot column equal to 0. So, what does that amount to, okay. So, what that amounts to is this guy, when we divide throughout by A11 becomes equal to 1, A12 becomes equal to this guy is going to be A12 divided by A11, which we will write A121. Okay, and B1 becomes B11, okay. So, this involves one division and the second division. So step one involves two divisions. The first part involves two divisions. What we do next is this particular row minus A21 multiplied by this row. By doing that, this particular element gets converted into 0. We know it is going to get converted into 0, so this computation is not done. A22 is going to be equal to, as we had seen earlier, if we look at this equation, A22 is going to be A22 minus this particular product. So there is one multiplication and one addition subtraction step. So that is going to convert A22 into A221. Okay. A221 is nothing but A22 minus A21, which was the old value over here, multiplied by A121. Okay. None of these numbers change. These numbers remain as they are, and B2 gets changed to B21. And again, using the equation that I had shown earlier, B21, remember, is nothing but B2 minus A21 multiplied by B1, which involves one addition subtraction and one multiplication division step. This involves one addition subtraction plus one multiplication division step. So we have two additions or and two multiplication division steps. Okay. So step one involves two addition subtraction steps plus four multiplication division steps in step one. Next, what is going to be step 2? Our step 2 is going to use this particular row as the pivot row. So in step 2, row 2 becomes the pivot row. Now let us look at what happens in step 2. Okay. So in step 1, row 1 was the pivot row. Instead of that, in step 2, row 2 is the pivot row and A221 is the pivot element. Okay. Now we are going to use the pivot row instead of R1, we will use the pivot row R2 to convert not A21 equal to 0, but A32 equal to 0. Okay. And this is going to change appropriately. Now again, let us go back and look at what that is going to involve. Okay. We are going to use this particular row, okay, to get zeros in this particular column, in this particular column below the diagonal. Okay. So if this is the diagonal, we need to get 0 over here and everything else below that is 0. So the only computation that we are going to do is for row 3. There is no computation that will be done for row 4, row 5 up to row n. Likewise, this A32 itself on its own is going to become 0 because we are going to multiply, divide, we are going to subtract from R3 this particular row appropriately. Okay. So this on its own is going to become 0. A33 will change because this is a non-zero element. Okay. And A332 is going to be nothing but A33 minus A32 multiplied by A23. Exactly the step that we did over here, a similar step will be done over here. A34 does not change because the guy over here is 0. Rest everything is 0, so none of these values change, and the only other value that changes is B3 becomes B32. Okay. This also requires one division step to convert this into 1. By dividing, this gets converted into 1, this gets converted into A232, and this gets converted into B22, where B22 is nothing but B21 divided by A221. Okay. So there is one division and two. There are two division steps exactly as we had earlier. There is going to be one addition, subtraction and one multiplication, division step to get this guy. There will be one addition, subtraction and one multiplication, division step to get this guy. So, 2 addition, subtraction plus 2 multiplication, divisions plus 2 multiplication, divisions over here. So, as before, we will have 2 addition, subtraction and 4 multiplication, division steps in step number 2 as well. Okay, and we are going to keep doing that for n minus 1 rows, just as we did in the Gauss elimination step. And that each of these steps is going to require 2 addition, subtraction plus 4 multiplication, division steps. So, total computational requirement is going to be n minus 1 multiplied by 2 plus n minus 1 multiplied by 4. These are the addition subtraction steps and these are the multiplication division steps. Okay, and this is exactly where the Thomas algorithm or the tri-diagonal matrix algorithm has an advantage over the Gauss elimination, that instead of this method being n to the power 3 this method having an n to the power 3 computational requirements has n to the power 1 computational requirements. So, when we go from n equal to 10 to n equal to 100, the number of computations required are going to go from order of 10. That means perhaps it is going to be 6 multiplied by 9. So, 9 times 6 is 54. So, it is going to go from 54 computations to 540 computations if we are going to use 100 steps. Okay. So, the amount of increase in effort with the increase in total number of n, when we are discretizing this type of a boundary, the amount of increase in effort is manageable when we are going to use a method such as a tri-diagonal matrix algorithm. Okay. So, with that I will come to end of this particular lecture, lecture 5 of module 3. What we basically covered in lecture 5 of module 3 is the Gauss elimination and tri-diagonal matrix algorithm, and we compared the two by looking at the amount of computation required for each step, and therefore we looked at the total computational requirement for both the Gauss elimination and the tri-diagonal matrix algorithm.